Manual manhood.
Manual manhood.
Automatic manhood.
Automatic manhood.
Manual manhood.
Manual manhood.
Automatic manhood.
Automatic manhood.
Igri Diogo.
Igri Diogo.
Igri Diogo.
Igri Diogo.
So this type of manhood is that type of manhood that is. Sit down, everybody. Sit down, everybody, please. So guys, see what I just wrote on the board. Can someone tell us what I mean by manhood, please?
Sir.
Yes, you?
A manhood is a dangerous and also a peaceful snake in between every man's leg.
That's very good. Clap for him, please. So guys, we have two types of manhood, which I'm going to write on the board. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So guys, who can read what I just wrote on the board, please?
Sir.
Yes, you, please.
Sir, manual manhood and automatic manhood.
Very good. Clap for him, please. So guys, repeat after me. Manual manhood.
Manual manhood.
Automatic manhood.
Automatic manhood.
Manual manhood.
Manual manhood.
Automatic manhood.
Automatic manhood.
Hey! So guys, I'm going to first of all start by explaining what I mean by manual manhood. So here we go.
Continue.
Manual manhood is that type of manhood that is always shy and will always pause and think before it can engage in any knacking activity. And if you convert this manual manhood to a car, you can even understand it more. Because a manual drive car is always needing the permission of the driver to select any gear. For example, now, if the driver of this particular manual manhood decides to put the gear of his manhood to gear one, which could be either his wife or his girlfriend, he can decide to travel from Nanka to Australia without changing that particular gear. Now you can understand why this type of manhood is called manual manhood, because it is full of self-control and it knows exactly when to act and when not to act. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So now let's go to the number two, which is automatic manhood. So this type of manhood is that type of manhood that is very shameless, very arrogant, and is always ready to cause havoc. So now, when the driver of this automatic manhood enters into a family of, let's say, five girls, he spares nobody. In fact, he can even extend his greetings to the girls' cousin sisters, both the beautiful and the ugly, including the neighbors. And if you also convert this type of manhood, which is the automatic manhood, to a car, you will also get an automatic car drive, but this time around with a slight difference. And that is because the driver of an automatic car drive must first of all put his car on a D, which is,
sir.
Yes, what is it?
Sir, what does the D stand for?
Okay, that D simply means drive. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So as I was saying, it takes the driver's efforts to first of all permit the car to drive him before the car will now start selecting gears automatically. But meanwhile, the driver or the owner of an automatic manhood doesn't have full control to activate his manhood, but rather the automatic manhood is fully in control of his owner. For example, now the driver or the owner of an automatic manhood might be sleeping in the middle of the night, and the automatic manhood can decide to wake him up in the middle of the night and order him to call Cynthia, and he dares not delay in calling Cynthia. And this very type of manhood, which is the automatic manhood, is always quick in action and is always quick to regret once he lands the owner or the driver of that particular manhood in trouble. And the last but not the least is that the owner or the driver of an automatic manhood always have many titles, and the most important and the most notable of those titles is called Igrigogo. I'm going to write on the board, please. So repeat after me, guys. Igrigogo. Igrigogo. Igrigogo.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, why is the owner of automatic manhood called Igrigogo?
The reason is because the driver or the owner of an automatic manhood is always in a fight with his manhood, even though he knows very well that his manhood will eventually win the fight. But this very title is given to him because of his relentless effort and willingness to fight. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, yes, what is it?
How can we easily know a man who has an automatic manhood?
Oh, that's very simple. Just look at your boyfriend's face.
Hey! Yeah! 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 Yeah!